Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, now we are going to do the topic of Hess law of constant heat summation and its application. So it is very much simple to understand that previous lecture we have studied what is the enthalpy of formation, and as well as we have also calculated that how it would be calculated for a reaction. So it is very much simple to understand Hess law right now. So now let us learn what is Hess law of constant heat summation. So there are the statements of it. So let us understand the statement of it. So it says that the change in enthalpy for a reaction is same whether the reaction takes place in one or series of steps. So what does this explain? It says that the enthalpy change for a reaction, that is suppose if a reaction is taking place from suppose A to C, and now it if it takes place in a series of steps also, suppose for a conversion of a series of steps, that is from A to C, that would be A to B or again B to C. So therefore in this case the series of step, if it would involve, that would be same as that of the heat of reaction for A to C. So it is very much simple to understand what is Hess law, but there are also different kind of its definition and what is say. Let us talk about that also. It says that the enthalpy change for a chemical reaction is same regardless of the path by which the reaction occurs. That means it depends, it doesn't depend on the path, it only depends on the final and the initial state, like that of a state function. It doesn't depend on the path of it, and it will depend on what is the initial state and what is the final state. Basically, what would be the reactant and what would be the product, and based on that, what would be the change in enthalpy. So it measures that, and that is nothing but that is applicable under Hess law. So let us understand this concept, that what does the Hess law was trying to convey when it comes to the heat of a reaction or enthalpy of a reaction. So for that we have an example so that I could tell you in a much more easy way, which is this that we have discussed earlier also. Suppose if we have a reaction, that is A to C, when A is being converted into C. So in this process, the change in enthalpy that we have observed, or the change in the heat of reaction, or the standard enthalpy of the reaction, suppose it is found to be delta H1. So, but this reaction can be written in a series of steps also. Suppose if the reaction takes place in two steps, that is from A to B, it spends, or the change in enthalpy that we could observe is delta H2. While again, suppose if another step has been carried out from B to C, and in this case the change in enthalpy has been found to be H3. So if we sum up these two things, so let us see what we could get. So if sum these two things, so this B which is present on the right hand side, as well as this B which is present on the left hand side, so suppose they will cancel out each other, and the overall net cell reaction that we could get is, that is A has been converted into C. But this is the similar reaction that we have got above, and in this case the energy that was being, the change in enthalpy that we have observed is nothing but the delta H1. So this clearly indicates that the delta H1 that we will get from A to C, it will be sum up of delta H2 plus delta H3, because delta H2 was the change in enthalpy when A was converted to B. But again, the B, if it converts to C, then the change is been found to be delta H3. So therefore, this, the sum up of this H2 and H3 will nothing will be the overall change in enthalpy from A to C that we have observed here. So this implies or this states the first condition of the Hess law that we have studied, that we have studied two statements. So the first statement was related to this one. So now the second statement that we have got to know, because this first statement, it was saying that if it depends on the number of series of steps, suppose, and if a reactant converts from A to C, then it can be, it, we could also calculate the series of step and we could add that. So that was the statement one of Hess law. But the another statement that was dependent, it was regarding the path. And it was independent on the path. As we could see here, it would be very much easy to understand. Suppose the reaction that we are making in consideration is A to C. So from A to C, the energy or the change in enthalpy that we have observed is delta H1. But when it is undergoing a series of steps and now it, suppose it changes the path, suppose this is the path A that we that you observe here. So in this case, suppose if A has been converted into B, an intermediate, and in which delta H2 has been spent, or delta H2 is the energy that change that we observe here in terms of enthalpy. And again, suppose in from B to C it comes and it gives an enthalpy change of H3. So the thing is, if it follows the path 1, it comes from A to C, and suppose if it follows path 2, that is from A to B, and again path 3 from B to C, ultimately the reactant A has to reach the product C. So whether it takes place in a single step or whether it takes place in a multiple step by following different paths, but the thing is, it does it the when it comes to the change in enthalpy of a particular reaction, that is from A to C, it will not depend on the path, it will just depend on the what was the reactant and what was the product, and based on that what would be the change in enthalpy that we would observe. So that was the Hess law that we have got to know now. So this is the thing that we have got to know from the Hess law statements, and but to understand it in a more better way, this was a general thing that you that I have explained, but just for a reason, suppose if we have such a reaction, so as to understand whether how the Hess law has been applicable in overall thermochemistry, let us talk about that. No, so suppose this is another example, and we have to make a consideration of how the preparation of methylene chloride is been done. So in this case, similar like the earlier one, as you could see that suppose it is following path 1 and path 2, suppose the path 1 is directly from A to C. Similarly in that way, suppose if methane is reacting with the chlorine molecules and the, all the substance are being present in a gaseous state. So in this process, what I could see is methane has been reacted with chlorine gas molecules, and from which it has been forming a methylene chloride as well as 2HCl. But in this formation of methylene chloride, what we could see is the enthalpy of the reaction, or the change in enthalpy in standard state, it has been formed to be minus 202.3 kilojoule. So this is the direct reaction, or the reaction that has took in a single step, so as to form so as to convert the methane to methylene chloride. But what if it follows multiple steps and it has chosen a different path? So what would be the overall heat of the reaction, or what would be the change in enthalpy of the reaction during conversion of a methane to methylene chloride? So for that we have path 2. And in this case, suppose if it follows two step, it is not necessary that it will always follow two step, it could be multiple step also, but for an instance I have provided this thing. So suppose if an example which follows two steps, so in this case suppose methane is been reacted with chlorine, because two moles of chlorine are been reacted or are been used. So suppose in this only one mole of chlorine gas has been reacted, so what will happen is we will get methyl chloride along with HCl. So during this process, basically the energy that is being changed, or the change in enthalpy that we observe, is nothing but minus 98.3 kilojoule. But in this case, the methyl chloride that has been obtained, it is not the methylene chloride, so we have to convert that methyl chloride to methylene chloride. So for that, the similarly the methyl chloride is now reacted with the chlorine, that was because we are using two moles, so another mole of chlorine gas will be used in this case, and in that case what will happen is we'll get methylene chloride along with HCl, and the change in enthalpy that we have got is basically minus 104.0 kilojoule. So during this process, the thing is which I want to talk about is, it is ultimately we'll get a conversion of methane to methylene, but the thing is it is following a multiple step, like step 1 and step 2, but we have got the product. But what would be the change in enthalpy? Will that be similar to that of the earlier reaction that has took place in a one step, or this would be different? So let us check that too. So for this thing, we'll do some kind of simultaneous equation that we have did in algebra also. So similar to that of the algebra that we have studied in our lower section, that is secondary section of our school, similarly we could solve this also. And so the thing that we could do is, we could cancel out this thing, that is this CH3Cl, and this CH3 cell which is present on the right hand side and on the left hand side. As well as if we would observe this thing, then the answer that we could get is, or the overall equation that we could get is nothing but CH4 plus 2 times of Cl2 gas, and again we would obtain that is CH2Cl2 plus 2 times of HCl. So this is the reaction that we will observe, that we'll get if we, even though if we follow the two-step process, and this would be similar to that of the reaction that has taken place in one step. But when we are talking about the change in enthalpy that we will observe, so the thing that we have did is we have sum up the step number 1 and sum up the step number 2, and because of which we have got this equation which was like that of in path 1. So similar to that, we could also arrange this thing for the change in enthalpy. So if we add up this minus 98.3 kilojoule with that of minus 104.0 kilojoule, then the answer would be again minus 202.3 kilojoule. So this implies that we are following Hess law. So this reaction, even though it has been following in a single step or even though it is following in a multiple step, but the thing that is much more essential for us is the reactant has been converted into the product, and during that kind of change it will be similar whether it follows single step or multiple step. So that is nothing but the Hess law regardless to that of the path followed by the system. So for that I have a short synopsis that what we have did in this reaction, so as to get much more a better understanding that what we have did in Hess law. And here it is. Our first target was to convert the methane, and we have to react it with 2 moles of chlorine gas, and we have to obtain CH2Cl2, that is methylene chloride, with that of 2 times of HCl. So in that process, basically when the reaction occurs directly in a one step, then we could observe that minus 202.3 kilojoule of energy has been that is, it has been evolved from the system, or basically we could say that the change in enthalpy that we have got is minus 202.3 kilojoule. Obviously, since it is minus sign, so we could easily say that it is a exothermic reaction. So what happens if this kind of step, it follows multiple step? For example, the main concern was our methane molecule. So if methane molecules react with 1 mole of Cl2, so in that process what happens is the change in enthalpy that we will observe, so as when the methane and chlorine molecule come back to form CH3Cl, that is methyl chloride plus HCl, and in that process basically minus 98.3 kilojoule of energy has been evolved basically from the system. So the CH3Cl again it will be reacted with the chlorine atom or chlorine molecules that we have, and so as to form CH2Cl2 plus 2 times HCl. So in that process basically the enthalpy change that we have got is minus 104 kilojoule. So this is the second step. This is the first step that we have got to know, and this is the second step that is written over here, as you could see, and you could analyze that also. So the energy that has been spent is basically 104. So if we sum up this two heat or we could say the enthalpy, then it would be similar to that of minus 202.3, because the both have the same energy level, as you could see. So this is nothing but Hess law. A very much simple thing to understand that how could a thermochemistry can be related to Hess law, and we could calculate different heat of reactions also. For example, suppose if we have a heat of reaction from CH4 to suppose the product CH2Cl2, and in this process suppose if we know the value of the conversion from CH3Cl and Cl2, which is being converted into CH2Cl2 plus 2 times HCl. So we could also analyze what would be the value or what will be the change in enthalpy when CH4, that is methane, when reacts with 1 mole of fluorine to form CH3Cl plus HCl. So this is the application of the Hess law. Means we could estimate what would be the reaction change in enthalpy of a particular reaction when it follows multiple steps. As well as if we know this two value, we could also assume that what would be the enthalpy of the overall step. And as well as suppose if we know this value and we know this value, then we could also evaluate what will be the change in enthalpy when this, that is CH3Cl plus Cl2, that will convert into CH2Cl, and that process what kind of energy will be evolved. So this is basically application that we have done. But let us understand more applications of the Hess law so that we could understand in a better way that and what kind of equations that are being used in solving a particular or calculating the enthalpy of reaction. So we have basically now we are talking about mainly we are talking about application of Hess law. Continuation. So now the first application is the thermochemical equation can be added, subtracted or multiplied by a number factor like ordinary algebraic equation that what I had told you earlier also because algebra equation that we have studied in our school level can be applied. So because it's very much easy to do this thing and it would be very much easy to calculate the heat of reaction or enthalpy or any kind of change in energy for a particular reaction. It is and therefore for calculating that the thing that we have to the operation that we have to do in that process is we can add we can subtract as well as we could multiply by a number factor and we could calculate a particular value. So talking about the another one that is suppose the enthalpy of a reaction which is cannot be determined experimentally can be calculated by Hess law. So that is what I have explained to you earlier also. Suppose if we don't know the value of and suppose we cannot calculate what will be the value of when methane is being reacted with chlorine and what would be the energy change that we could observe. Suppose if this we cannot calculate it. So by doing this reference by doing algebra like we have did well that we have talked about earlier also we could do that thing and we could easily calculate what would be the enthalpy of that particular reaction. It's very much simple to understand. And talking about the last one that is because of Hess law, there are few enthalpy that we could calculate. So now what we are going to do, now let us learn what is the third application of that. So the third application says that it can be used to calculate the enthalpy of a reaction which do not occur directly. So the reaction that do not occur directly, we could also calculate that what would be the change in enthalpy of that particular reaction. As well as we have discussed that earlier also. And the enthalpy of formation of any compound from its element can also be calculated by using the Hess law. As well as the enthalpy of combustion is also can be calculated by using Hess law. So this all are the application that we have did and based on that we have studied that how important does the Hess law of constant heat summation plays a very vital role in understanding a particular chemical reaction. So this was it and a very easy concept. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this Hess law very much more efficiently and you'll share this video with your friends too. And share this video with your friends and yes, don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.